Adobe Premiere Pro really gives you so many options when it comes to the effects. In fact, there are well over 100 of them, and I don't have time to show you all of them, of course, but I do want to show you how to add them and manipulate the effects, because that is the same no matter what the effects are that you want to utilize. And so there are two places, though, that you can get to the effects. The most obvious that you might be thinking about is when you navigate over here to the Effects tab. You click on the Effects tab, you navigate to the Video Effects folder, click on this so that the arrow points down to reveal all the subcategories. And then, of course, there are so many here. I mean, image control for black and white, generate for lens flare, lightning, all kinds of stuff here. I mean, there's so many here. You can do color correction, chroma keying. But this is where you add effects. You simply click on one of these and drag and drop it into the clip. However, before we do that, I want to show you the other area that I call where the basic effects are for all video clips. So simply click on a clip, make sure your playhead's parked on that clip. So you click on the clip, you navigate up to the Effects Controls tab. And once you do that, you'll see what I'm talking about. You have video effects, the basics, what I'll call the basics. You have motion, opacity, time remapping, even audio volume and effects from the clip that's down in the sequence. Okay. The interesting thing about these effects, real quick, is if you were to navigate over and double click on a video clip and load it into the source window and you go back to the Effects Controls tab, it's not there. Those effects are not there. You have to have a clip down in the sequence, double click on it, or click on it once actually, and then go up to the Effects Controls tab, and then you'll see these effects. So kind of interesting how that works, but these are the two places. The Effects Controls tab, the default basic effects, and then of course these effects over here. So let's start with these. The motion effect, if you want to manipulate any one of these effects, right? You simply go to that category, click on the triangle to the left so that it points down. And this has to do with scaling, position, rotating. So I'll give you an example. If I want to manipulate the scale part of this video, which means I'll resize the video, I can mouse click and drag to the right numerically to zoom in, or drag it to the left to zoom out. And this is how I would do a picture in picture. This is the beginning of a picture in picture. The default is 100%. So I can type in the value, right? I'll type in 100, enter, and then it goes back to its normal or original size. The position, if I click on this, I'll get this option for a keyframe, which is what I just created. But more importantly, if you click on the category, which is right here, motion, then I get this little area that I can drag. I can drag it anywhere. I can mouse click and drag and reposition the clip. And then I get these points here that I can also mouse click and drag. And then I can rotate, mouse click and drag, and I can rotate left and right. All kinds of cool little features here. Now, if you want to go back, you can undo. If you want to reset what you've done, navigate back over to the category, right? You can reset it here, or reset the entire effect by clicking on this. And that will reset this entire motion category. There's more here. Here's the rotation, the anchor point. This would really take a little more time to explain all of these, but these are the basics. Position and scale and rotation. Those are probably the most common when it comes to manipulating your clips and your sequence. There's more. Opacity, when you're stacking video, you click on this, you can change the opacity value here. Mouse click and drag, your cursor will disappear when you're dragging. I'm actually changing the opacity, so because this is the only clip where my playhead is, when I change the opacity, it's actually going to fade to black because there's nothing underneath it. So these are the basic effects that you should get familiar with first. All of these, including things like volume. Right? You can navigate over here to volume and increase or decrease the volume of the clip in the sequence, right? That's already placed down here in the sequence. Okay. So with that said, I'm going to navigate over here, go over to the Effects tab. This is important too. And I'm going to select one of these. Let's keep it simple for the first effect. I'll mouse click on this black and white effect, otherwise known as a filter. I'll throw that out there. I'll mouse click on this, and it's simple. I'll just drag and drop it into the clip. And when I do that, of course, with my playhead parked on the clip, two things happen. I can see what I did up here in the program window, and I can also see the effect here underneath the basic, or in between the video basic effects and the audio effects. Here it is, black and white. Now, there isn't much manipulation you can do to this particular one, so I'm going to click on this to delete it. It's simple. I'll push delete and it goes away. You cannot delete these basic effects, right? If I click on the motion and I push delete, it doesn't go anywhere. It stays there. By default, these are locked, I'll say. So let's have some fun. If I want to go to, let's say, four color gradient, I'll mouse click on this. I can now drag this up here and let it go, or down here to the clip and let it go. So either way, I'll let it go. And some of these you might think, wow, what's going on? I don't know what's happening. Well, again, you park your play it on the clip. You click once on the clip. You'll see that you've added an effect, right, with this little green button here, this little green icon, effects, that indicates there's a filter or an effect there. Then you come over here to the effects controls tab and you have some fun. Now I happen to know with this particular one, I'm not going to change these colors, but the blending mode is what makes the difference, because there's none. I won't be able to see these colors until I mouse click and select, I think it's overlay, there we go, or any one of these will probably give you a different effect. But that's the cool thing about Premiere. You have all these options to really do some cool things to your video. Now once you have something like this added to your clip, then you can just simply mouse click and drag and get a preview of what you're doing. And this is pretty interesting, but I can play this and watch it. So I'll push the play button on my program window. And although I do have a color here, red, that indicates it's gonna have a harder time playing this particular effect. This could be over a clip or it could be over a transition. All the red means is that Premiere will play it, it just won't have the full res and the frame rate that you want, but you can still preview it. Okay, so that's pretty cool. So how do we get rid of an effect? Click on the clip, navigate up to the effects controls tab, go over to the actual effect itself, push delete, and it goes away. What about something a little more interesting like lens flare? Drag that on there, that's really cool. I could do the same thing with the effects control. I could add a keyframe by clicking on this guy right here to add a keyframe. I can mouse click and drag that to a different spot. And actually I want to drag my play to the beginning, right? And make sure that this keyframe is at the beginning. More on this on a different advanced set of lessons that I'll be coming out with soon. But basically, then I'll drag my playhead over, and I'll check this out. When I want to manipulate this particular effect, I'll click on the lens flare itself, the name, which gives me the option then to mouse click and drag, right? In fact, I'm going to navigate to this fit option and select 25% so I can see outside of the visual area of the video. And while I'm still on this last keyframe, I'll drag this out like that. And that's pretty cool. Now I can also drag this keyframe over so it goes right to the end of the clip. And now when I change this back to fit, I drag this back, that lens flare will move. It may not be the best looking effect that I've ever done, but I can animate my filters. That's really cool too. Have some fun with this, you guys. In fact, I'm gonna get rid of this lens flare. I'll click on the name of the effect here in the effects controls tab. I'll delete it. I mean, there's all kinds of things here. There's lightning. I can add lightning to this and it actually looks pretty cool. I can manipulate it just like I did that previous effect. Now, a word of caution, there's so much going on with a lot of these effects. I would suggest you get good at one or two, practice, and then add to that, because you can quickly get deep in a mess if you're working on an actual project and you're not sure what you've done. What you do know, though, is you can get rid of it and start over. Simply go to the name of the effect here in the effects controls tab, select it, push delete, you can start all over. So have fun with these effects. There's a many, many powerful features here in Premiere Pro that you can practice with. And then, of course, when you're ready to move on to the next lesson, you'll be all set with this one that we covered effects with.